بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, I testify that there is no true God worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad is Allah's true slave and messenger. This is the explanation of Riyad al-Salihin, and this hadith is hadith number 5. وعن أبي يزيد معن بن يزيد بن الأخنس رضي الله عنهم، وهو وأبوه وجده صحابيون، قال: كان أبي يزيد أخرج دنانير يتصدق بها، فوضعها عند رجل في المسجد، فجئت فأخذتها فأتيته بها، فقال: والله ما إياك أردت. فخاصمته إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، فقال: لك ما نويت يا يزيد، ولك ما أخذت يا معن. And the hadith is reported by Al-Bukhari. In it, Ma'an bin Yazid bin Al-Akhnas, may Allah be pleased with them all, he, his father, and his grandfather were all companions, reported that his father, he said, my father set aside some dinars, this is the silver currency then, for charity, and gave them to a man in the mosque. I went to that man and took back those dinars. He said, I had not intended you to be given. So we went to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and put forth the matter before him, and he said to my father, لَكَ مَا نَوَيْتَ يَا يَزِيد. Yazid, you have been rewarded for what you intended. And he said to me, مَعَن وَلَكَ مَا أَخَفْتَ يَا مَعَن. And مَعَن, you are entitled to what you have taken. This hadith, still we are explaining the hadiths under the chapter of Ikhlas, of sincerity. And this hadith, which the author rahimahullah mentioned in the story of Ma'an, the son of Yazid, and his father, may Allah be pleased with them both, that his father Yazid sent to a man in the mosque, entrusted him to give away some of the charity, to distribute it to the poor people. So his son came and took it. And it's possible that this entrusted person may have not known that he was the son of Yazid, and it's also possible that he gave it to him because he was entitled and deserving to that. So the matter reached his father Yazid, and he said, مَا إِيَّاكَ أَرَدْتْ, meaning, it wasn't you that I intended. I had not intended you to be given this charity. So he went to the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, and the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, لَكَ يَا يَزِيدُ مَا نَوَيْتْ. Yazid, you have been rewarded, you have been rewarded for what you intended. And وَلَكَ يَا مَعْنُ مَا أَخَذْتَ. And he said to Ma'an, you are entitled to what you have taken. So the Prophet ﷺ saying, لَكَ يَا يَزِيدُ مَا نَوَيْتَ, Yazid, you have been rewarded for what you intended, indicates that actions are but by intention. They depend upon intention. And that if the person intends good, then he is rewarded for his intention. Even though Yazid did not intend for his son to take this charity, but he took it, and his son was from those entitled to take, so it was his. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at the end of the hadith said, لَكَ يَا مَعْنُ مَا أَخَذْتَ. مَعْن, you are entitled to what you have taken. So in this hadith there is evidence for what the author, may Allah's mercy be upon him, focused in his chapter about the purity of intention, and that the person will be rewarded for that which he intended, even though the matter may occur in a way not intended actually to be as planned. And this matter, there are many other matters related to it. For example, these things mentioned, or many things mentioned by the ulama, by the learned scholars of Islam, rahimahumullah, that if the person intends, or if the person gives his zakah to someone, the due annual charity upon the person, the zakah, if he gives the zakah to some person thinking that he is a deserving person entitled to receive the zakah, then afterwards it becomes apparent to him that he, this person to whom he gave the money, was rich and he was not from the people of zakah. In this case, his zakah is legally considered as freeing him from the responsibility. So he, as if he gave the zakah to someone who deserves it, so it is legally sufficient, there is no problem with that, and therefore it is acceptable, rendering him free from responsibility in terms of the duty of giving the zakah, because he intended to give the zakah to someone who deserves it. So, and therefore he will be rewarded for his intention. This is one case. Another case, if someone wants to put an endowment, waqf, for example, a small house, he intends a small house, and then he says, I put such and such house as an endowment, and he points in the direction of a big house, which is opposite to that which he intended in his heart, and he will be therefore considered in accordance with his intention, not in accordance with what his tongue bursted out of, or bursted out impulsively, you know, with his utterance. No, but in accordance with that which he intended. Another case, if some ignorant person does not know the difference between Hajj and Umrah, and so he went for Hajj with the people, and he said, Labbayka Hajjan, Labbayka Hajjan, O Allah, here I come for Hajj. I respond and I offer Hajj. I respond to offer Hajj. While he intends Umrah, but he uttered the Hajj, yet he intended Umrah. Umrah what? As enjoyment for Hajj, so that he can perform Hajj of Tamattu', the Hajj of Tamattu', which comprises Umrah first and then Hajj. So he will be rewarded in accordance with his intention, as long as his intention here is the Umrah. However, he uttered the Hajj with the people, he will be rewarded for that which he intended, and he is not harmed by the burst, the impulsive burst on his tongue as to the Hajj. Another case, if someone says to his wife, you are taliq, 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 quote, free, which means divorce, right? Fine. Taliq. And he intends by the word taliq that you are free from all this kind of restrictions except the marriage. Then he is taken by that which he is intended, which he intends. And in this case, his wife is not considered as taliq, meaning the divorce does not actualize. So this hadith, therefore, there's a lot of benefits from this hadith. And many, many branches are related to this hadith in the chapters of fiqh. And from the benefits of this hadith is that it is permissible for the person to give charity to his son. It is permissible for the person to give charity to his son. And the evidence for this is that the Prophet ﷺ commanded charity and incited people to do it and to give the charity. So Zainab, the wife of Abdullah bin Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with them both, intended to give away in charity some of her wealth. So her husband Abdullah bin Mas'ud said to her, myself and your children are more entitled to be given this charity of yours, because he was poor. May Allah be pleased with them both. So she said no, until I ask the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So she came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasalam and she asked, and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, Sadaqa ibn Mas'ud. Ibn Mas'ud spoke the truth. Your son or your children and your husband are more entitled to be given the charity. And this hadith is in Sahih al-Bukhari. Also from the benefits of this hadith, that it is permissible for the person to give his son from the zakah, with the condition that he doesn't intend from this to drop off a wajib upon him, to drop off an obligation upon him. For example, if someone has zakah and he intends to give it to his son, but he intends that so that his son does not demand the nafaqah from him, he does not demand that his father fulfill his obligation of spending upon him, then in this case it is not permissible, because he intended to drop off or free himself from the obligation of spending on his children. However, if he gives it to him in order that his son can pay off a certain loan, for example, or something which is required from him to pay, suppose the son was involved in a car accident and he carries on some of the responsibility, financial responsibility in the accident. In this case, the father may give him from the zakah in order to cover such responsibility. There is no problem in that. And because his son is the most related to him, and he does not intend from this to drop a wajib, an obligation, and to free himself from that, but rather he wanted to free his son's responsibility. And in this case, if this is the intention, then the zakah is permissible upon the son. Wallahu al-muwaffiq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who grants success. And this brings the end of the explanation of this hadith, hadith number 5 from Riyad al-Salihin. والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.